So before starting, I would like you to go through the disclaimer so that you can't sue me anytime soon. Read it carefully. If you feel that you are fascinated by listening to me, then you are advised to seek professional help from engineers to implement AI in your discipline. 141 years ago, mankind invented and adopted electricity, which transformed the world as we know. AI, that is artificial intelligence, is the new electricity and will now do the same. An important question is coming into my mind. What is AI? For many people, it remains unclear what this technology is all about. So this is a good place to start the conversation. AI is a branch of computer science that deals with the intelligent behavior of machines. It is the ability of a machine to imitate human behavior. So this is made possible with specific algorithms that make the AI function for various activities. That reminded me of my disclaimer. So no technical discussions, no technical suggestions and definitions. I'll just come to the point. So this means that with AI, many of our everyday activities can now be carried out effectively by program machine technology. And further, COVID-19 definitely has accelerated the adoption of AI. So AI is not for engineers, but it's for everyone. So understanding AI technologies and spotting opportunities to apply AI to problems in your own work is what is required. You will see how through examples of what today's AI can do. Finally, you will understand how AI is impacting society and how to navigate through this technological change. AI needs your perspective. That's it. If you're thinking that smart cars or sci-fi things of AI don't personally affect you, as they are still not in your country or in your city, so how about something which you use on a daily basis? And you will soon divert yourself in that direction once we go through the ease that AI has provided to us on a regular basis. So let's see one by one how AI has taken its place in our daily lives. Do you know Google receives over 63,000 searches per second on any given day? That's the average figure of how many people use Google a day, which translates into, for example, maybe 3.8 million searches per minute, or it may be, if calculated, 228 million searches per hour. And if in a day, it is 5.6 billion per day. And if you talk about the year, it is 2 trillion searches per year. So that is the huge amount of AI that is actually has evolved itself into our life. How it is being done? Have you ever noticed that when you enter something onto your search query in the Google search bar, you get certain results showing links, images, or videos? While typing, you must have noticed before you complete the sentence, it gives you suggestions. So all happening in the background is AI. AI in a Google collects data about your search history, about the videos you must have watched in the previous few days, ads you must have clicked, or your location, the websites you must have visited, and the devices you use, and based on that gives you the search suggestions. Now see how personalized that Google provides. Of course, this is at a little cost at your privacy. Now that's a different part of story, that nothing is hidden from Google. And some information that Google does not collect, we users provide the consent to do that. Just be careful in future, including name, birthdays, gender, and even our passwords. When we click, we don't have to enter the password again, so save the password. So that is how it is being done. This data is basically being used to enhance your experience with Google search and the suggestions according to your need. So you won't be surprised to know that Google takes over 200 factors into account before it delivers you the best results or the best suggestions for your query, and that too within a fraction of a second. Snapchat. Everyone might be aware of this Snapchat. Most fascinating one for the young generation, and of course for some of us too. For a computer to put a dog's nose on your face at appropriate place and not replacing your ears or eyes, it needs to do more complex calculations to locate your facial features. Now, this is done by using an active shape model. Computers relying on this model draw on manual marking of the human that indicates the borders, that indicates facial features, and the thousands of images are being done. So I'm not going to discuss any algorithm over here, but yes, just an idea that how it checks. If you weren't convinced yet that artificial intelligence will eventually be able to do pretty much anything, the Snapchat is about to show you just how powerful AI can be. The popular social media app Snapchat has added a new lens called Time Machine. So that's capable of aging and de-aging your face. Some of you must have noticed it through some of the WhatsApp messages that have been shared in the past with you. It is not reality, of course, but yes, you can see it through your smartphone. At least you can look younger and you can look smarter. I have not used any AI for this video. So Snapchat is again one major example of AI. Let's see another smartphone service or another smart service in our emails. Every day we write mails and reply to the mails, maybe about at least 100 mails in a day. So email categories like primary, social, promotions in your Gmail account automatically receive corresponding mails. How it is based on the header information and your previous behavior for the reception of emails. Similarly, junk mails. Now the junk mails are automatically thrown to junk or the bulk folder. How it is being done? So after estimating the mode of generation, example for some email marketing server, it is being categorized into a junk folder. And also by typing the email, you must have noticed that there some phrase you get sometimes, just like, hi, I hope you are fine, doing great, greetings and all. So this is automatically filled as if your mail knows what you are going to write or what you are going to reply to a person. Now how this is being done? This is being done with the help of AI when it checks what kind of content is there in the mail. Accordingly, it gives you the suggestions. So, and it designs the phrase accordingly. Now, the best part is the smart replies. Just you can see over here, instead of suggesting words or short phrases, it offers you three responses to the mail that you would like to give in reply to your mail. Now that three responses might suit your email. For example, so if I'm getting some mail, reminding of an appointment, so the smart reply may suggest responses like confirmed, thanks probably, or I can't make it. You can see these three suggested highlighted in blue over here. In this screen, yes, I confirm, thank you, I will do that, and so on. So these are the suggestions that is given by the server based on the content of the mail. So don't go to the mails. This is confidential that I have taken from my email account. So just see the responses or the suggestions that is being given in the blue. So if you have not done it now, just utilize this thing and go to the settings and go to the mail settings and start working on the smart options there. Check out all the options, smart options that are available in your email, and you will get all the facilities, all the AI facilities that are available in your email. mail down. Again, coming to next, you might be familiar with some of the symbols that I have quoted over here. Everyone is. Even if you are living under a rock, or there is a high probability that you are tweeting from the underneath also. And if Twitter is not your choice of poison, I'm sorry, there may be some social media geeks over here, so I'm still quoting it as a poison. So there may be Facebook or the Instagram, or you may be on a Snapchat or at least WhatsApp, which now also some of you might be doing or checking. So well, if you are using any social media, most of your decisions are being impacted by AI. How it is being done? That is done when you get the feeds that you see in your timeline or sometimes in your notifications that you receive from these apps. So everything is curated by AI. It checks your interest area and suggests. Netflix check your interest area and suggests you the movies. Similarly, the Facebook checks your timeline and suggests you. Google Assistant is helping you for any of the tasks that you want to automate on your mobile phones. So a lot of options are available in which AI is helping you out in a daily routine, whether we just note it or not. Now, the sole purpose of AI, what is the purpose of AI in this? It is just to make you more addictive, give you a user-friendly access to that. And however hard you try to keep yourself away from these social media apps, you cannot do that because AI is winning the war against you. So if it is being done, so let's shake hands with AI. However, there are still some skeptics out there. Let us take a few more examples. How about the navigation or a travel industry? Now, most of us travel from time to time and use the navigation on almost daily basis while booking Ubers, Olas and all. So what is being done? You are using Google Maps or you are using Apple Maps for navigating or calling a Uber or maybe flight ticket that you are booking. All is using AI. See the dynamic pricing. That is how the AI works. Well, if you don't know this before, it's time to open your eyes. Both Google and Apple, along with their navigation services, use AI to interpret hundreds and thousands of data points that they receive, and then they give you a real-time traffic scenario. When you are calling an Uber, both the pricing and the car matches your ride request. That is decided by AI. So as you can see now in all these applications, that AI is important in our daily life. And probably we now cannot think of living without AI. So if we know that we cannot live without AI, then it is time to convince ourselves to use AI in our professions and in our disciplines as well. So let's see how AI is making changes in your respective disciplines. Not quoting only about the Moonshots project that was handled by MD Anderson Cancer Center, there are many hospitals that have successfully adopted AI patient care as well. Healthcare people might be aware of this fact. The use of artificial intelligence has given a new dimension altogether to the healthcare. With the introduction of AI-powered machines, it becomes very, very easy to diagnose the disease. Moreover, it is also playing a significant role in making the treatment simpler and also managing the hospitals simpler. As a result, hospitals and healthcare centers are fast embracing AI-enabled technologies. That is where AI is entering in the healthcare sector, but the only glitch is that it is able to perform only one task at a time. Now, if you see that AI has entered and soon it is going to replace even face-to-face counseling sessions or face-to-face interaction with the doctors itself that normally we are doing nowadays in the COVID season. According to stats, if you see, AI market in healthcare will increase up to tenfold 2025, and it will become enormous, 13 billion industry or more by 2025. So from 2016 to 2025, the growth has been tremendous. $90 billion industry is seeking support of AI. So now healthcare is one thing that is further being shaped by AI. Not only healthcare, agriculture as well. So if you talk of IBM, Microsoft, Farmer Edge, Deer End Company, Climate Corporation, all these are big players in the AI agriculture market. Now, why it is important in the agriculture? We need to understand there is no fundamental need than the need of the food. And this will never go away. Fortunately, the use of AI will allow farms of all sizes to operate and function, keeping our world fed. Through the use of agriculture, through the use of cognitive technologies, maybe farms across the world are able to run more efficiently to produce the fundamental staples of our dietary lifestyle. Now, it is the noblest and the oldest profession. And as the world population is growing, land is becoming more and more scarce. We need to have the techniques to get the more produced from a lesser area of the land. So where is the solution? The solution is AI. Now AI is controlling all the details, all the requirements of a particular crop, even predicting the weather, even predicting the seasons, and telling farmers that how they should go about the agriculture or the crop in their respective areas. Now, the complete data that has been collected from the agriculture sector is being used to provide the information to the farmers about seasons, about seeds, about growth, and what all the facilities or what all benefits they can have from AI. But there are so many agriculture related tasks that have been ideally been replaced by AI. Let it be a quality of any particular produce. Now, once there comes the identification of the best quality produced and the rotten fruits and all. So AI is the area which selects each and every produce from the farm and categorize them into the good, best, or maybe the better, or maybe the worst one. So this is how it is helping in the farming. So agriculture is another sector, which is a major one and is not untouched by AI now. Coming to architecture, very interesting area. Marvelous architectures can be envisioned and created using AI. Any planning to construct a building for which you are not prepared can be done with AI. Sometimes you need years of planning, years of hard work to bring the architect's vision to life. I think the people who are from architecture background might, you know, quote me right over here, that it takes a lot of efforts, you know, to design something and then to give it a real shape. So this is where AI can be a powerful tool. AI will make the planning process of the architect significantly easier, giving them access to countless amount of data. Creating models, interpreting the building environments, and creating cost estimates, all this information can be easily conveyed to the architects to help shorten design and building time. A lot of data is available about the buildings, about the architectural details in the past, which can be utilized by the architects to create a new designs. Now on the construction side, if you think, again, AI can assist with actually constructing something with little to no manpower. Now this may work in the areas where human accessibility is very low. Maybe, you know, underneath the sea, or maybe, you know, uphill, where the human beings cannot go easily. So these are the areas where AI can help in doing the construction as well. So even currently, you know, MIT researchers are creating AI-powered drones. So that will be having the ability to communicate with each other to construct small models. Spacemaker AI is one of the company, you know, if you check and explore it much, they are into providing the solutions for architectures and building constructions. Marvelous architectures have been created by using the tools provided by them. And then you can use definitely AI to construct those marvelous architectures as well. So architecture is one field which is again not untouched by AI. Coming to hotel industry, I know many of you might be feeling hungry as of now. The hotel industry, very much, not many people might be seeing that in the hotel industry, now there are robots that are serving food. When the comfort defining advancements are most rapidly incorporated in our hotel industry, it has sophisticated entire system and the adoption of many innovative methods have been done in this industry for providing, you know, customer satisfaction. AI robots not only diminish the human involvement into this, but also it is kind of a voice activated assistant nowadays. It has already smartened the way hotel guest services delivered to customer satisfaction. You can always use your Alexa or Siri for this purpose, but then hotel industry is having their own assistants, which is actually guiding and helping the customers. Now, from the customer's small specific need to the major requirements, everything is being catered by these AI-enabled assistants. If you talk of Apple Siri, now it has started providing voice-activated assistance to mobile users to an extent that it has now almost become a norm for most of the people who are using, you know, Apple. Amazon Echo, Alexa, they have also joined the category in this way. And it gives a very delightful experience to the users and gives actually the powerful view of the AI. Okay, coming to a few hotels, you may be aware of Las Vegas, a giant hub, you know, posh world-class hotels are located there. So they offer exceptional luxury and customer experience. When the Las Vegas hotel series or chains is integrating Amazon Echo to digitize its maybe more than 4,000 rooms, you know, in order to offer their guests a tremendous control over multiple facilities using mere voice. Clarion Hotel, say in Stockholm, is also making its name on the list for the first hotels to use AI-enabled chatbot butler. So see how AI is entering into hospitality sector as well. If you think AI can't enter the culinary, so you are wrong in that. It already has. IBM's Chef Watson, it's an AI chef, you can say, gives us the glimpse of the creative potential for artificial intelligence. Although Chef Watson's recipe might suggest ingredient combinations and maybe the style of dishes which humans would never have considered, but its ability to analyze the data and overlay the scientific info makes, you know, working in the kitchen very effective. So it can work with the human chefs and can give the wonderful ideas of mixing the ingredients and suggestions thereafter. One hotel in Japan, Hana Hotel, so it has taken robots to work as a staff and even to serve the hotel guests as well. Now from the front desk where AI-powered robotic concierge service stands in the hotel rooms where voice-activated assistants accelerate customer service, etc. So AI has seen successfully driving hotel industry and it is entering now to each and every area. So if you want to experience something new, look out for some hotels which are already started giving you the AI option. We always used to think that art is one thing which is a creative thing and which is quite much attached to human beings. We we are the ones who can create a good artwork. But it is again not untouched by AI. So AI in painting is very, very important. One great example, the AI painting titled Portrait of Edmond de Bellamy, it was sold for $4,32,000 around a year or 2 years back. So that is more than 40 times the estimated selling price that was assumed in 2018. So Christie's became the first auction house to put an artwork generated by an algorithm. Algorithm was, of course, designed by AI, through AI only. Now, when the abstract portrait was sold by the company in a New York branch, everyone was kind of astonished that how AI can enter into the artwork. Now, whether it is applied to paintings, photography, video, music, the concept is always the same. Choose a piece of artwork whose style you want to recreate, then let the algorithm apply that style to a different image. Or choose several styles of art and let the AI produce a mashup of those styles and then incrementally blend those styles. So this is how AI is giving you an ideas to remix the things and develop a new artwork. Another form of imitation similar to style transfer is image-to-image translation. So which can convincingly change the appearance of the photo or the video. Probably the smart cameras has all those features. So if you want to change, you know, the location or maybe the particular image, you can choose actually that how that place would look like when it's sunny, when it's raining, when it's, you know, winter, when it's summer. So every time. So that is how easily you can, you know, predict that how this place will look like while implementing AI in artwork. So that is again very, very important. All these were businesses only. So every business, if not utilizing AI, should definitely start looking for it now. Now, Coca-Cola's global market and extensive product list, more than 500 drink brands sold in more than 200 countries, makes it a large beverage company in the world, probably the largest one. Not only does the company create a lot of data, but it has embraced AI technology and actually is putting that data into practice for development, for employing the bots, and also even the applying augmented reality in their bottling plants. So this is how the large businesses are adopting AI. Some of you, those who might be having little daughters, must be aware of Hello Barbie app. So what it does is Hello Barbie listens and responds to a child. A microphone on the Barbie's necklace records what is said and transmits it to the server of the toy talk. And then that recording, voice recording, is analyzed and to determine the appropriate response from 8,000 lines of dialogues, it checks what the child is saying. Based on that, it recommends the suggestions to a children. Maybe based on, you know, the accessories of the Barbie and everything. So this is how the AI is working in your life. So business is not going about, say, knowing the customers or the, it is also about knowing the competitors. So how you can check. Definitely, you cannot call your competitor and ask what you are doing. Okay, where have you reached? So the way is to check the data from social media sites, from internet, check the blogs, analyze the data, and then come to the conclusion. Now, who will do that? It is definitely AI. Okay. I missed one thing, journalism. Journalism is again, has been reshaped by using AI. In fact, you know, in Bloomberg News, one of the leading media publishing houses has claimed that the company has been using automated technology for publishing 1/3 of their news content on the platform. Media houses like the Washington Post, New York Times have been using U-boats to report and write the news. In fact, Washington Post has been using a boat called Heliograph since some time to publish news for their publications. Now, this boat is helping the website to be maintained specifically. And a simple example was, you know, this boat helped the website successfully reporting the Rio Olympics, you know, in 2016. So this is how AI has entered into the journalism. Another exciting industry, a fashion industry. Now, China-based fashion retail giant Alibaba, since 2018, it has adopted the technologies that have revolutionized their shopping experience. With the launch of their first fashion AI store, the company introduced in-store features. Smart garments are there, smart garment tags are there, intelligent mirrors are there, along with the Bluetooth chips that are embedded in every product, so that you can actually see how you look in a different attire from that smart mirror. H&M Group, most of you might be aware of, they are combining both analytics and AI with human intelligence to use what is known as amplified intelligence. Now, Stitch Fix, another company, founded in 2011, obviously, it is a company that provides a personal style service for both men and women. Now, they use data from both customers and clients to create an accurate result for the users. Tommy Hilfiger, most of you are aware of this. So this company, in partnership with IBM, has pioneered in reimagined retail, a project that is equipping fashion designers with AI skills for designing. So as a result, fashion students could learn a plethora of technical skills, maybe a natural language processing to understand what the client is going to tell them, or maybe a computer vision for the personalized experience of the clients. AI is everywhere, then how the education sector will not be affected by this? So my apologies for taking the education sector towards the end, as it was important for us as an educators to understand that how AI has impacted our disciplines, to understand how deeply we are impacted by AI, so as to prepare future workforce accordingly. That is why this has been taken towards the end. And if we have to prepare the future workforce where AI has entered all areas, then our curriculum must be redefined, redesigned, of course, with the help of AI itself. That is the stage where we have landed in. For us to reap the fruits in future, you know, the sapling needs to be planted much earlier, that we are aware of. So the interest in AI should be created right from the primary school education. It will not happen in a day. The interest will not be created in a day. It will only happen when we expose the young kids to AI by giving them access to the AI tools. Some personalized AI learning tutors are available. Some schools are really using it. There are several companies such as Content Technologies and Carnegie Learning currently are developing, you know, intelligent instruction design and digital platforms that is using AI to provide learning and testing and also to giving feedback to the students about their learning. Now, as AI is getting more and more sophisticated, it might be possible for the machine to read the expression of the child who is sitting in front of the machine to understand whether the student has understood the concept or not. Accordingly, it will showcase the content. If the content is too difficult for the student to understand, it may simply suggest the basic content to the student to have the prior knowledge of that area. One such tool is Carnegie Learning's Mica software is there. It is using cognitive science and AI technologies to provide personalized tutoring. And also it is giving a real-time feedback for post-secondary education students as well. NetX Learning is again one example which the educators are using to design digital curriculum and the content across devices. Now it is also providing a personalized tutoring or real-time feedback for post-secondary education students. Some of you might be aware of, say, online placement processes that have been happening. Some of the students who have been told to write, you know, maybe a paragraph in English and all, how it is being evaluated. Now, AI is the one that is actually assessing the communication skills of the student who is appearing for any, you know, one-to-one or placement activities and all. So it is being checked with the help of keywords. So if a particular topic is given to the student, so on that topic, the AI is going to check the keywords, number of keywords that have been used. So if the data is matching with the list that has already been fed in the AI, so it can definitely, you know, give the marks to the student. This is how the most of the assessments are happening nowadays, which is kind of a descriptive type of an assessment. And, you know, some assessments are totally AI assisted. For example, you must have seen the students who start working on some learning management platforms and all will be showcased maybe a questions with a higher difficulty level. If you are able to, if a student is able to solve the query of level one, then next time maybe a question of level two or a difficulty level two will be thrown in front of a student. And if the student is able to clear that, next time it will be of difficulty level three. So this is how the AI is picking up in the education sector as well. So now I think I have almost touched all the application areas, keeping, I suppose, the disclaimer in my mind. But please do not be afraid of AI. It is not there to harm us. It is there to assist humans. So we have to adopt it wholeheartedly. So now you see, AI is getting omnipresent very fast. So light your bulb now and leave the rest. So thank you all. You can reach out to me for any queries. You can just type in the chat box. I'm still working into bots. So you can just put your questions into chat box and or you can reach me out for any of your queries. I would be happy to answer that. Just forgot, Google AI must have captured, you know, the content I stole from the Google search. So before these companies and the Google sue me for that, I should thank them for the references. So thank you all.